I'm not sure if you use the term that you're an optimist, but you seem that you don't let things get you too down. And I feel like that's one of the keys to people remaining in this town, because there's so many things that knock people down on a daily basis. And it feels like the world's turning around. Oh, the heavens are opening up. And then, bam, there you go again. That's just kind of what it is, whatever you're pursuing here.
Yeah, I'm an optimist, the cup half full. I feel very blessed. I've got a wonderful family. my media company produced 275 videos. Company got hacked, crashed 3 years ago. Now I've got another film. I'm very happy with what I just did. Blessed with great producing partners, great cast, great crew. Then I'll be doing Forbidden Zone 2 right after that. So I feel very blessed.
Okay, so when one of these things happens that seems earth-shattering, do you see it as earth-shattering, or do you say, let me get a good night's sleep, let me have a great barbecue and a glass of wine, and then tomorrow's a new day?
Yeah, that's me.
Okay.
I love to cook for my cast and crews. Nice. So I do famous barbecues, and I do theatrical parties.
Ooh, okay.
So there's always something.
Sure.
And I just, I thank God, for some reason, I just don't stay down. Shit happens.
There you go. Yeah.
You know, of course shit happens. You know, but, I bounce back.
You bounce back. Were you always like this? This has always been your makeup?
I'm trying to think. Other than that rough period in middle school where I was just had so much, and then I cracked and kind of like went to the dark side. Oh, one thing it did teach me is I have more empathy for young kids that get into trouble, kind of understanding the reasons why. So I did come out a more empathetic character. When I see teenagers get into trouble,
sure,
for one reason or another, knowing that there's reasons and that they're potentially good souls.